Hello students, so here I am with another problem on isometric projection, and this very special method that is known as box method. Actually, as already I discussed with you that in solids there will be two solids, you can say three solids actually. One will be cube, second will be a square prism, third will be a cuboid. These three types of solids are having all the lines as isometric lines. As in the plane we discussed that a rectangle and a square will be a planes having all the sides as isometric lines. So as normally when we draw different planes isometric, we will bound those planes inside a rectangle. Same way if you want to draw the isometric of a solid, then you will bound that solid in a cuboid. Most of the time that will be bounded in a cuboid. Here I have selected a problem that there will be, this is a problem of frustum of hexagonal pyramid, and the frustum of hexagonal pyramid will be like that. Its base, lower base will be 50 mm side, top base will be 30 mm side, and axis will be 75 mm side. So here I have drawn the top view of that frustum of hexagonal pyramid. So in the top view we can see two hexagons, one 50 side, second 30 side, and this is the top view. There is no need to draw the front view, as we know that height will be given to us. Now what we will do, that we will bound the outer hexagon inside a rectangle. So from this line AB we will extend AB in both the directions, same way ED in both the directions, then from F point and C point draw perpendiculars on the AB extension, and the whole figure will be bounded inside a hexagon. Earlier we also have already drawn hexagonal prism, so in that also we bounded this hexagon in a rectangle. After bounding this in a rectangle, here I will start with our three axes. One, this side, that will be the side. This one, this side, shorter side, and then this longer side will be on this 30 axis, and then the third will be the height, that is 75 mm. So I got this parallelogram, then go downside. Now I will complete, with help of these three axes, I will complete this a complete cuboid. So now this hexagonal pyramid can be bounded, frustum of hexagonal pyramid can be bounded inside this cuboid. So what is the way to the shift the point? Look at this figure. In this, the top hexagon, that will be 1 2 3 4 5 6. If I draw a line from extension 1 2 and name it PQ, opposite side from 4 5, that is PQ. So the distance of this PQ from this side, as we have kept this side on this length, this 30 30 axis. So this point and this point, so I can easily draw these lines in this figure also like this, and this center 3 and 6 point will be on the center line, so that can also be drawn like this. So on these three lines we can easily find out, locate all these 6 point of the top base, and the method will be again with the help of a compass. You can easily mark these points. This is the length. This is the length of 1, 2, 4 and 5. So 1 point, 2nd point, 3rd point and 3rd point and I can easily mark these 4 points, that is 1, 2, 4 and 5. For 3 and 6, this is the distance from this end, 1 point and 2nd point. So the points will be like this, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If I join all those points, you can get the top base of this hexagonal frustum of hexagonal pyramid So in this way we can copy this figure inside this box. Now regarding the lower points, as you already know that this AB will be on this line. So the distance of A and B, AB, then E and D from the opposite ends will be same. So first point and second point, that is A and B, then in the opposite side that will be D point. Then regarding this F, you can mark it on this and C. So already I have marked these points. Look at these points. This is A, this will be B, this is C, this point will be D, and this side we have this point F. Upside, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So in the lower portion also you can match these AB. Then from AB to BC, then from B to C to D. Now you can join this 3 with C like this, this 2 with B, this 1 with A, and F will be inside, so there is no need for use of F. Now join this D with 4. So this is the way. So look at the figure. We got isometric projection of this hexagonal prism. Just you have to draw this box and these shift all those points in the same sequence as they are in this figure. So this is the way to draw isometric projection of a frustum of hexagonal pyramid with the help of box method. I hope you understand the concepts. Try and practice this problem. I think more things you will understand about how we are going to locate the different points in the different solids. Thank you.